Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about configuring and managing the Oracle network. To configure and managing the Oracle network, Oracle provides the tool called Oracle Net Configuration Assistant. It is launched by Oracle Universal Installer when you install the Oracle database software. The Oracle Net Configuration Assistant, we can call it as a NetCA, enables you to configure the listener protocol and the service information for an Oracle database. So if you want to configure the listener or if you want to configure the any service information, you can do it by using the NetCA. During the typical database installation, whenever you are installing the database, Oracle Net Configuration Assistant automatically configure the listener named call listener. By default, Oracle is configuring the one listener, has a TCP IP listener protocol address for the database. Next, naming method. So Oracle Net support several method for resolving the connections information. So first one is a easy connect naming, which is using only the TCP IP connection string. Second one, local naming, it is using the configuration file. Third one, directory naming, it's using a centralized LDAP compliance directory server. And the fourth one, external naming, it's user supported non-Oracle naming services. So here we are going to see the description of each and every naming method. Easy connection naming method. So easy connection naming methods enables client to connect to the Oracle database server by using the TCP IP connection string, consist of the host name, optional port and service name as follow. So here you can see, if you want to connect from the client machine to server machine, what you require? You require the command called connect, username, password, then host name, port number and service name. Here you don't require any kind of additional configuration. You should know only the host name, port number and service name, so you can easily connect to the your database server. The easy connect naming method requires the no configuration. Here you no additional configuration is required. Next, local naming. The local naming method stores the connection description in the configuration file named tnsnames.ora file on the client machine. Here you require the configuration and one file is created on the client machine that the name is called tnsnames.ora, where all this information, host name, port number and service naming, everything is stored under the tnsnames.ora file. Next, directory naming method. So directory naming method, basically to access the database services, the directory naming method stores the connection identifier to centralized directory server that is compliant with the lightweight directory access protocol that is called as a LDAP. This is the third method. Fourth, external naming method. The external naming method stores the net service names in a supported non-Oracle naming services. Supported third party services including like network information services, NIC, distributed computing environment, DC, cell directory services, CDSS. Fine. So in this session, we have discussed about naming method and Oracle listener. Next, we are going to see practical session, how to configure listener and how to configure the naming method.
Hello friends, let's discuss about how to configure Oracle listener. So database is already started on my machine. Here we can see select name, open mode from V dollar database. So this is the database started. I'm opening a new terminal window and I'm configuring the Oracle listener. So here using NetCA we can configure the listener. NetCA, full form of the NetCA is Network Configuration Assistant. Using this tool you can configure the listener. This tool is by default installed whenever you are installing the Oracle database software. So NetCA, enter. Just issue the command on the terminal window, NetCA, and then press the enter. So here you can see this is the graphical tool. Welcome to the Oracle Net Configuration Assistant. This tool will take you through the common configuration step listed below. So you can just configure the naming method, you can configure the listener. So first of all, we are going to configure the listener. So listener configuration, just click on next. What you want to do, you just want to add the new listener. So first of all, just click on next. What is the name of your listener? This is the name of your listener. Fine. If you want to change the name of the listener, listener 1, listener 2, whatever you want to give, you can just give. By default, we are going to give the name is listener. Next, which protocol you want to use to configure the listener? That is the TCP protocol. Okay. Next is a port number. Which port, on which port you want to just configure the listener? So port number by default Oracle is giving you, that is the 1521. Here if you want to just use any different port, you can just also give the different port number like 1522, 1523 like this. Here by default we are going to use the 1521. Would you like to configure the another listener? No, only one listener is enough at this moment. Just click on next. So this process will take some time. So listener configuration is completed. Just click on next and click on finish. So here you just finish the your listener configuration. So here important thing is that once you configure the listener, whether the listener is started or not, it is stop or not, what is the status of the listener, that you should know. Once the listener is started, then user can connect, client user can connect to the your database, otherwise they can't connect to the your database. So first of all, I'm just showing you the listener file, cd Oracle Home Network Admin, and here you can see at this location Oracle Home Network Admin fine listener.ora fine listener.ora. This is the file for the listener. So here you can just check the file, the content of the listener. So here you can see this is the content of the listener. Description list, description, protocol TCP, host, this is the your local host 1521. So these things we have configured. So whatever the things we have done using the tool, that in that tool it creates this file and store at this location. Fine, this is the physical file of the listener.ora. Next is just check listener is up and running or not, or listener is stop, or how to start the listener, how to stop the listener. So here this is the command you have, lsnrctl status. Fine, so here you can just check whether the listener is up and running or not. So here you can see lsnrctl status. Fine, lsnrctl status. So this is the listener alias name, status of the listener, alias listener version, this is the version for the listener, start date. So this is the start date, uptime, trace level, security. Fine, these are the all these things of the your status of your listener, and at this moment listener is up and running. If it is not up and running, it will just show you the message listener is not available. Fine, so here you can see if you want to stop the listener, you can just stop in this way. So this is stopping the listener. So once you stop the listener, no one can connect to your database from the client machine or some other machine. So the command is completed. Now you can just check the status. So no listener. Fine, here you can see the message no listener. Again, if you want to start the listener, you can just issue the command start. Fine, listener is started. Here listener is also providing the command line utility. So just issue this command lsnrctl. Fine, you can just check the status of the listener from here directly. If you don't want to write down from the this here, if you want to just write down on the command prompt, you can just write down here command line utility. Fine, lsnrctl, just check the status. Fine, ls here if you want to stop the listener, you can just stop, you can just start the listener, you can just start the listener. Fine, so in this way you can configure the listener, start the listener, stop the listener. Next is naming method. See, once you configure the listener, means server side configuration for the network environment is done. Means if the user want to connect to the your Oracle database, user can connect if the listener is up and running. If the listener is not up and running, user can't connect it. Fine, so the important thing is that the first thing is that on server your listener should be up and running. Now once the listener is configured, next thing is that if the client want to connect to the your server machine, how client can connect. So for that, on client machine you need to configure the naming methods. Fine, so different naming methods you have. So let's discuss about it. So here I am not going to some other client machine. On the same machine, I am just showing you how to configure the naming method. So basically, we have two naming method. First one is easy name connect method, and the second one local naming method, that is the using the configure file. So easy connect naming method, it uses the TCP/IP connection stream. Fine, this is the first method, easy connect naming method. Using this method, you no need to do any kind of configuration. You no need to do any kind of configuration in the first easy connect naming method. So here connect username password, host name you need to provide, port number you need to provide, and the service name you need to provide. Additional configuration is not required. So from the client machine, if you are providing your username password with the host information, with the port information, with the service name, fine, you can directly connect to your database. Here again I am repeating, no additional configuration is required. So let's see how to do this stuff. So here, see, I'm just connecting to the SQL plus. Fine. So I'm just connecting the sys as a sysdba, export oracle sid equal to orcl and sql plus. You need to just set up the environment variable sys as a sysdba orcl. Fine. So I'm just connecting to the with the sys user. Now from here, if I just want to connect to the Scott user, fine, how can I connect? So I am just issuing the command Scott Tiger, fine, and I am just using the easy name connect method. So here username password, host name, what is the host name you are providing? Localhost. Fine, port number and service name. So here your account is locked. So at this moment the Scott user is locked. So I am just unlocking it. No issue. Alter user Scott. I am just issuing the password identified by type. Fine. Account unlock. So here what I need to do, simple. Now again I am just connecting. So this is the easy name connect method, no additional configuration is required. Just issue the username password with the local host connected. Fine. So this is method is called easy name connection method. Connect Scott Tiger at localhost 1521/ ORCL, this is the your service name. So these things you require additionally if you want to connect from client machine to server machine, and this method is called as the easy naming method. Additional configuration is not required. But important thing is that as a user, as a client user, you should know the your host, database host name, port number and service name. Now if you as a database administrator, if you don't want to provide all this information to the client user, you can use the different method, that is your TNS. Fine, you need to configure the TNS. So here second method, local naming, here you need to just configure the file, and here you need to just add the entry into TNS names.ora file. So how to do this stuff using NetCA, you can just perform. So let's see. Local net service name configuration. So here using this option you can just configure the TNS. So let's see, add service name, just provide the service name ORCL TCP protocol, host name localhost, Do you want to perform the test? Yes. So invalid username password, we are just doing this caught tiger, connecting test successful, next, and net service name, that is the ORC, fine, next. Would you like to configure the another net service name? No, one is fine at this moment. So here we have just configured the another local naming method, that is the TNS. So here you can see, once you configure the TNS, so let's go to this location, you will find the one more file, that is the TNS names.ora. Here you have added the entry, so let's see TNS names.ora. This is the entry added, and using this local naming method you need to just connect to the your Oracle database. So I am just showing you, first of all just see the content of the file. So this is the TNS names.ora 1521 localhost, and the service name is ORCL. Now if you want to connect to the your Oracle database using this naming method, how can you connect? So let's see. I am just first of all connecting to CSDBA. By default I am just connecting, and from here or the from the directly from the SQL prompt, if you want to connect, just issue the command scott tiger ORCL connected. So here this content is available inside the file, and user just need to pass the naming method. This is the ORCL that it needs to pass. That's it, simple. No any additional information is required, local host, what is the my host name, what is the my port number, fine, what is the service name, that nothing is required from the user end. It only requires the ORCL, this is the connection string it's required. That simple thing, ORCL, it contains everything inside it. But you need to require the additional configuration, that is the inside the TNS names.ora file, you need to just add the entry using the netca, fine. So here if I am just issuing the command again, scott tiger, and I am just issuing the command ORCL1, let's see. So TNS could not resolve the connection identifier specified, fine. So this thing is basically required, okay, ORCL or the previous method we have just seen, easy naming connection method, this methods we required if you want to connect to the Oracle database from the client machine. You need to configure that, either use the easy naming connection method which require the not even single configuration, and if you want to use the local naming method, you need to just configure the TNS, fine, using the netca. So here again I am just issuing the command ORCL, fine, connected. So in this session we have discussed about how to configure the listener and how to configure the two naming method, that is the easy naming connection easy naming method to connect to their Oracle database from client machine, and second one is the local naming method, in that you need to just configure the TNS names.ora file.